What have Pennsylvanians paid the benefit? What he really did was he convinced everybody that if you put a Marcellus Shale tax on, you could pay for education. If prices go back up and you have a severance tax, which is based upon the cost of the sale price and the volume, you had a lot of drilling, you might be able to get a substantial amount more. There is one really essential problem, and I'll make it this easy. Let's say I had a donut shop, and I said I wanted, you said, how much are you going to make next year? And I said, I'm going to make $1 million. You said, okay, how much do you make per donut? And I said, $1. I want to do the math easy so I can do it in my head. And you said, how many donuts do you make? 100,000. You said, well, 1 times 100,000 is 100,000. How you can make $1 million? You're not making $1 million in donuts. Well, maybe I will. Well, your production can't get there. That's our problem. We can drill, we can pull the stuff out, we can't get it to market. There's not enough ways to transport it. We have to use rail car and tractor trailer because we don't have enough pipeline. So what's happening is industries looking to get build pipelines. But pipelines become private property. So the way you build a pipeline is, if the three of us are companies that drill, we formulate a fourth company that we each own. We then build a pipeline at big cost, and then only we use it. So it's for the three of us. When he has his gas, we don't let him use our pipeline. It's our pipeline. So now he has to build his own pipeline. And so we end up with a state like this, with no real supply chain. And guess where we want to send our natural gas? Where the price is the highest. Where would that be? China? New England? You know, you name it. China right now is an energy hog. They are buying coal up like crazy, polluting the whole world. So where does he want to send his gas? Same place. I want the gas to go to Pennsylvania. So the way to do that is this. You get, first of all, you have to get the federal government to give you authority to use the interstates the right of way. Right now, no private entities or public-private entities can use the right of way. You use Interstate 80, 79 in the turnpike. You got a whole block of the state. Use the right of way through a public authority, and you deliver the gas as it goes to Pennsylvanians. The company that builds that will be owned as an asset by the authority, so any gas producer can use it. They pay a fee, and we use that to maintain our highways, our interstates, and our turnpike. It's one easy solution. And now we put gas where people are going to want it, where the vehicles are going to travel. We create an infrastructure, we create revenue for Pennsylvanians, and we deliver the gas to Pennsylvania. Anybody have propane here? I have two propane heaters. I pay as much for propane as you would for oil, maybe more. Even though the cost, because you can't get propane, so they price it equivalent to oil. But propane's a cheaper, it's a cleaner gas. They don't, you know, oil, you get that smell. So it's projected that if you just did the turnpike, the northeast extension of the turnpike, you would have 100,000 new manufacturing jobs in Pennsylvania. Because you have places all along the turnpike that are zoned commercial where you would build your new factory because you'd have cheap energy. So there's solutions, but you got to get busy. Other thoughts? I know, you got to go. Good. Get the kids off. What grade?
Kindergarten.
Awesome. I passed a bunch of parents today putting their kids on the school. You knew it was their first day because it was 1 o'clock and they all had cameras and they were taking pictures.
What can the everyday person do? I mean, a lot of these